Hello, this is Bishop Jonathan Ferriol, and this is the Bishop's Take. We call them the frontliners, doctors, nurses, and a host of other healthcare professionals working day and night fighting the spread of this dreaded virus called COVID-19. Trusted into a battle against an invisible enemy they barely know, these frontliners are risking their own lives, saving the world one patient at a time. And many of them across the globe have already paid dearly with their own lives combating this virus. But undeterred, they continue charging into each day in longer shifts, their gowns barely changed, and their masks and gloves almost wearing thin from overuse. Yet, our modern heroes are not retreating anytime at all. Their goal, stop this virus before it could stop the rest of us. Sleep-deprived and ill-equipped, our medical frontliners embody the best in humanity in the worst of times. For them, it's no longer just about earning a living, but saving the living. Their care and attention to the critically ill is nothing short of heroic. Their battle scars on their faces show that they are not working anymore for themselves, but for those whom they have grown to accept as their trusts. As the world reels from this pandemic, our frontliners are the ones keeping the situation steady and from turning into a complete chaos. It is only fitting that the governments of the nations must give their unequivocal support and assistance to them. The leaders of our countries must never permit them to fight this dreaded virus with their hand tied behind their backs. They must be supplied and equipped with every essential protective equipment, masks, gloves, shields, and gowns, for them to fight and win this battle. Meanwhile, all citizens of the world must throw their support as well to them, from cheering them on during their breaks, feeding them, gassing their vehicles, and even praying for them. Let us do our share to enable them succeed in their fight. In Romans chapter 13, the Bible says that all authorities are established by God. Our medical frontliners may not be serving necessarily in the executive or legislative branches of our government, but I personally believe that they are also authorities to a certain extent. Hence, we typically follow their prescriptions and their medical guidelines. I cannot stress enough the need that we follow their guidelines, especially these days that this pandemic is not showing any sign of stopping. Like our medical frontliners, our church leaders, headed by the good man of the house, are frontliners themselves, albeit in the spiritual realm. We must also support and partner with them during this COVID-19 ravaged times. Let's pray for them as well, that they lead the church against the forces of darkness. Our frontliners need us just as much we need them. This is my take on the frontliners. May God bless them.